concert band concert. I'm Keith DeFore, the Dean of the Division of Fine Arts. Before we begin the concert, we'd like to make the announcement that early this morning, Shirley McGinnis passed away. Shirley McGinnis was a longtime supporter of fine arts at Young Harris College. In fact, she and her husband, Richard, gave a significant gift to the college that allowed for the renovation of this wonderful facility about a decade ago. We are truly indebted to the McGinnises. Please join me in a moment of silence in memory of Shirley McGinnis. Thank you. Enjoy our concert band in Glenn-McGinnis.
to all of you. Thank you so much for being here. I'm Dr. Hayes Bunch. I'm the director of bands here at Young Harris College, and it's my privilege to lead these fine musicians in front of you on a journey each day, sonically, and it's a real treat. And so we're glad you're here to allow us to share and explore these works with you. The piece you just heard, Samuel Coleridge Taylor, the Danse Nègre from his the African Suite, actually. And so Samuel Coleridge Taylor studied at the Royal College of Music. He worked under notable professor Charles Villiers Stanford, and early on he caught the attention of a renowned composer, Sir Edward Elgar, eventually earning him a commission through Elgar's music publisher. And Coleridge Taylor wrote his four-movement African Suite for piano first in 1898, and 2 years after the success of his Ballade in A Minor, and as a result of meeting African-American poet Paul Laurence Dunbar, who encouraged the young man at the time to explore his African heritage. And so tonight we presented, hopefully, a high-energy fourth and final movement of the African Suite. We appreciate you being here again. Our next work, Three Pieces for Band, from 1967 by Philip Rhodes. Philip Rhodes was born in Forest City, North Carolina, so just right next door to us, in 1940, and he received degrees from Duke University and the Yale University School of Music. His principal teachers were William Klines, Ian Hamilton, Donald Martino, and Mel Powell. Rhodes has been the recipient of numerous commissions and composition awards, including grants from the National Endowment for the Arts, the National Endowment for the Humanities, the Rockefeller Fund for Music, a citation and award from the American Academy of Arts and Letters, a Guggenheim Fellowship, two Tanglewood Orchestra Prizes, and two McKnight Foundation Fellowships, two Fromm Foundation Commissions from Harvard, and the Bush Foundation Fellowship as well. So major performances have covered the globe. The Atlanta Symphony, right next door to us here at Carnegie Hall with the Atlanta Symphony, Cleveland Orchestra, the National Symphony at the Kennedy Center for the Arts as well. He is an Andrew W. Mellon Professor of Humanities Emeritus at Carleton College and served as the composer in residence there from 1974 to 2007. His three pieces for band that we'll present for you tonight was commissioned by the National Band Association in 1968. The basis of musical organization in this work is a 12-tone row composition. So the row of notes is constructed in the shape of a wedge. So you imagine the smallest musical interval going out to the largest musical interval from a shape standpoint. And that is that basically becomes the impetus or the catalyst for the entire work, is that wedge shape that you'll hear. The first movement, Entrata, is intended to give you, the listener, sort of a glimpse in bits and pieces, so to speak, of the musical material that will become the basis of the subsequent movements. The second movement, the Passacaglia, is based on an 8-note theme and a 4-note accompanying chord that you'll hear. The theme itself is derived from a rearrangement of that original 12-note row, while the remaining notes comprise the accompanying chord structure. And then in that second movement, you'll hear three counter-subjects or themes used in the Passacaglia. And you'll hear these first in the low reeds and brass, the second in the high woodwinds, and the last is given to the first trumpets. The final movement, Variations, is a type of rondo form with variations and uses previously heard material set between these recurring brass fanfare passages that you'll hear from our trumpet section. So please enjoy Philip Rhodes' Three Pieces for Band.
Thank you.
Thank you all so much. Composer, conductor, and teacher. She studied at the Paris Conservatory, and believing that she had no particular talent as a composer, she gave up writing music and became a teacher in that capacity. She influenced generations of young composers. Notables among her students were Burt Bacharach, Daniel Barenboim, the conductor, Elliot Carter, Aaron Copland, John Elliott Gardner, Philip Glass, Roy Harris, Quincy Jones, Astor Piazzolla, Carol Husa, and Virgil Thompson. A Boulanger various academy, including the Juilliard School, the Longy School, the Royal Academy of Music. Boulanger was the first woman to conduct many major orchestras in America and Europe, including the BBC Symphony, Boston Symphony, New York Philharmonic. Let's try this again. Sorry. New York Philharmonic Orchestra. She conducted several world premieres, including works by Copland and Stravinsky. The Prelude in F minor is the first movement of Boulanger's three pieces for organ, composed in 1911 and published in 1912. The music is rather pensive and reflective, and at times very dramatic and highly expressive. And Boulanger's really conservative and lean writing, if you will, is counterbalanced by her astonishing use of timbre throughout the piece. So please enjoy the Prelude, the first movement of Three Pieces for Organ by Nadia.
Thank you.
you all so much. Commissioned by the Buffalo Philharmonic, the Dallas Wind Symphony, the Netherlands Drum Ensemble, the Syracuse Symphony, Tokyo Kasei Wind Orchestra, and the Canadian Pats, to name a few. Solo works have been written for a multitude of really fantastic, internationally renowned soloists, such as Adam Unsworth, formerly of the Philadelphia Orchestra, the great clarinetist Larry Combs, formerly of the Chicago Symphony, and others. And he's received grants from the National Endowment for the Arts and awards such as the Sousa Foundation's Sudbury International Wind Band Competition. Dana Wilson holds a doctorate from the Eastman School of Music and is a Charles A. Dana Professor Emeritus at the Ithaca College School of Music. The work we're going to present of his tonight is called Say, and it's constructed of phrases that are basically repeated over and over throughout the work, but in various combinations to provide interesting growth. And the pieces boast the technical ingredients found in the traditional musics of certain non-Western cultures in a lot of popular American music that you hear today, and increasingly in Western concert music, if you will. The composer has always provided fresh outlooks on band works, and with saying, he explores sort of this interconnectivity between rhythmic utterances and typical wind instrument sound production by having players actually vocalize with and without their instruments. So the piece also includes a fair amount of extended percussion along with the vocalizations. And I think percussion, are we settled back there? Good. So with that, please enjoy Dana Wilson's Say.
Say, say, who got the tape? Who got the tape? Tape, it's tape.
and his mastery of technique and expression was imitated and admired internationally, universally, if you will. Justin wrote both sacred and secular music, and in all significant vocal forms of the age, including masses, motets, chansons, and so forth. And during the 16th century, he was praised for both his supreme melodic gift and his use of really sort of ingenious technical devices. Based on his vocal motet, Tu Patrum Refugium, Thou Art the Refuge of the Poor, this work begins with really soul-settling chords and then moves off into sort of a complex polyphonic arrangement that his
so forth, chamber music, and also music for the web. Recent works include a concerto for alto saxophone for Joe Luloff at the Michigan State University Wind Symphony, and then also a concerto for trombone for the great Joseph Alessi at the Dallas Wind Symphony. He's had numerous commissions from groups like the University of Texas Wind Ensemble, the United States Air Force Band, and so forth. And Stephen has also served as a distinguished visiting professor of composition at the University of North Carolina, Greensboro. Brian states the following about the work we're going to present tonight, his Metamarch. He says, Metamarch was the third after his Chester Musin and Impersonations, but before Sweet Dreams, but my parody sweet pieces that quote and rework familiar themes from popular works for band. He says, I wanted to create a march movement for the parody suite, so I chose three familiar marches that you'll hear tonight, American Tweed, Liberty Bell March, and National Emblem as source material, and ended up weaving in fragments from his own Chester Leaps In and Impersonations to further out, round out what he calls a postmodern self-referential nature of the piece, all tied together in a mostly straightforward march. While including all these various work quotes, I wanted this piece to still sound like a march. Above all, it's intended to be humorous. I hope it brings you a smile. So thank you all again so much for supporting the Young Harris College Division of Fine Arts, the Department of Music, and the Young Harris College Band.